Hello everyone.
Mr.
We are so grateful to have this moment of sharing the word of God. I believe now you are used to the evening fellowship. So this is the blessed moment that God has given us to share his word. So let me pray as we begin today's evening fellowship. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time. Lord, we thank you for your love and mercy. Now you have invited to meet in this platform in order to share the gospel, in order to share word. Lord, I can see that you do everything so that people can realize the gospel and be born again. Lord, in the past, we never knew that we can share the word of God online in this way. However, the Bible says that all things work together for the good to those who love God. Lord, I pray for the hearts of all followers who are with us tonight. Please humble down their hearts so that they can receive the word as it is. We believe the Holy Spirit will work, Lord, to allow us to realize your heart through the Bible. We thank you, Father. We pray all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
So today we're going to read from the book of Matthew chapter 7. Matthew chapter 7, starting from verse 24. Up to verse 29. So I hope we can open those scriptures and share the word from those scriptures. Matthew chapter 7, verse 24 up to
28.
Therefore, whoever hears the sayings of mine and does them, I will liken him to a wise man who built his house on the rock. And the rain descended, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on that house, and it did not fall, for it was founded on the rock. But everyone who hears this, these sayings of mine and does not do them will be like a foolish man who built his house on the sand. And the rain descended, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on that house, and it fell, and great was its fall. And so it was when Jesus had ended these sayings that the people were astonished at his teaching. For he taught them as one having authority and not as the scribes. Yes, we have read up to verse 29. I don't know whether you know this story of Matthew chapter 7. But this is the longest sermon ever preached by Jesus Christ. Which means, starting from Matthew chapter 5, chapter 6, and chapter 7, Jesus was speaking continuously. And if we meet the heart of Jesus, you know, through this long sermon at the mountain, so our life can be blessed. Here in this scripture, it contains, you know, the whole heart of God towards human beings. All people want to go to heaven. That's why they need to know what is the requirement of God. You know, our own preparations don't matter. Even if you prepare your best with all of your heart, but if it doesn't meet the requirements of God, then everything will be meaningless. So the servant of God, my pastor, sometimes like to give this example. Now, students, you know, enroll themselves to go to university. But what determines them to go to the university, it is the decision of the leadership of the university. Now, even if you prepare money for tuition, and then you also prepare all the materials, you prepare the house where you'll be living, now all the books, you know, and you know the material. If the school does not allow you, then all the preparations that you have prepared will be useless. Now, in the same way also, although you want to go to heaven, but you need to know what is the standard of God. What is the requirement that God is asking for people to go to heaven? Now, here in the book of Matthew, chapter 5, chapter 6, chapter 7, everything was explained in detail. Now, let's read one verse in the book of Matthew, chapter 5. Today I want to start talking about what is the requirement of God. Now we can read the book of Matthew chapter 5, starting from verse
3.
Yes. Now here the Bible says, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven." Now Jesus said, "Blessed are the poor in spirit." Who are these people? Because for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Now this is one of the requirements for you to enter into the kingdom of heaven. What is it? Now, Bible is talking about the poor in spirit, or the poor in their hearts. Now, one day Jesus gave a parable and said, two people went to the mountain to pray. One was a Pharisee and another one was a tax collector. Now, arriving at the mountain, both of them began to pray, speaking to God. Now the Pharisee began saying, "God, I thank you that I'm not like this tax collector and other sinful people. Me, I'm not dirty, I'm not evil like these, you know, sinners. Always I fast twice in a week. In my life, I never cease to give offering and tithes. I'm a person who always pray to God fasting. I'm a person who does so many good things." Now, when you check, you know, the structure of his heart, now his heart was filled with so many things that he did towards God. Now, always he could have, you know, fasting prayers. And sincerely also he could give, you know, offering and tithe of all his possessions. Every time he read the Bible, he could try to keep the law so much. Now, when he stood before God, we can see how his heart was filled with so many things to boast and to speak out to God. Now, such kind of people, the Bible calls them the rich in their spirit. And now Jesus said, "Blessed are the poor in the spirit." Now, after praying, now it was the turn of this tax collector. And now Jesus said, when the tax collector prayed, He had nothing to speak to God.
Umukoresha w'ikorwa yasengaga ntacyo yari afite yabwira Imana.
He could only beat on his chest.
Yakubise mu gituza.
Now the Bible says he couldn't even dare to look up into the heaven.
Biravuga ngo nta nubwo yategetse kubura amaso ngo arebe mu ijuru.
Now in the eyes of God he was very shameful.
Maso Imana yari afite isoni.
Just beat on his chest and said, Lord, please have mercy on me, for I'm a sinful man.
Yikubise mu gituza agira ati Mana mbabarira ngiye kuko ndi umunyabyaha.
This person, he was a poor in his heart or poor in the spirit.
Bivuze rero ko uyu muntu ari umukene mu buryo bw'umwuka mutima we.
Now Jesus said that, you know, after that, this tax collector was justified rather than this Pharisee.
Irivuga ko umukoresha w'ikoro ari we watsindishijwe kuruta umufarisayo.
So this Bible is amazing.
Ibibiliya rero biratangaje.
Many people, instead of looking at the heart of God,
abantu benshi bari kwita ku mutima w'Imana.
They only focus on their own heart.
Usanga bita ku mitima yabo gusa.
How they do,
uko bakora,
how they live,
uko babayeho.
Now they think those things are important.
Bakumva ko ibyo bintu ari ingenzi.
However, when you look at this, you know, Sermon on the Mountain,
ariko witegereje icyigisho cyo ku musozi,
when Jesus began preaching, he said,
ubwo Yesu yatangira kuvuga yaravuze ati,
blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs the kingdom of heaven.
Bahirwa bakene mu mitima yabo kuko ubwami bwo mu ijuru ari ubwabo.
Now at this moment let us look at ourselves and check our hearts.
Rero reka uyu munsi turebe imitima yacu twigenzure.
How do we stand before God?
Ese ni gute duhagarara imbere y'Imana?
Are you really poor in your spirit?
Ese koko uri umukene mu mutima?
Or you are very rich in your spirit?
Cyangwa uri umukire?
Many people pursue this richness of their heart, of their spirit.
Abantu benshi usanga bakurikira ubukungu bafite mu mitima yabo.
Now we call this religious life.
Iki rero tucyita ubuzima bw'idini.
Many times we want to do many things for God.
Akenshi usanga dushaka gukora ibyiza ku Mana.
We want to pile up, you know, so many good things, so many good works, so that we can present them before God when we stand in front of Him.
Usanga dushaka kurunda ibintu byiza hanyuma tukabifata tukabijyana imbere y'Imana.
However, people cannot realize that this is a deceit of Satan.
Ariko akandi abantu usanga badatora ko cyari igishuko cya Satani.
Now who was justified among between the tax collector and this Pharisee according to Jesus?
Ese ninde watsindishijwe hagati y'umukoresha w'ikoro n'umufarisayo ushingiye ku byo yavuze?
So now we can see the way that God is leading people and the way in which Satan is misleading people.
Aha ngaha dushobora kubabonera inzira Satani yoboramo abantu n'uko Imana iyobora abantu.
Now this Bible is like a mirror to our heart.
Rero Bibiliya ni nk'indorerwamo y'imitima yacu.
Now as you're checking in our heart,
iyo tugenzura imitima yacu,
we are able to see what kind of thoughts we live with.
Tubasha kubona ibitekerezo tubana nabyo ibyo ari byo.
Then we compare them with the word of God.
Tukabigereranya n'ijambo ry'Imana.
Many times I lived like this Pharisee in my spiritual life.
Igihe kinini nabayeho nk'uyu mufarisayo mu buzima bwanjye bw'amoko.
And I thought, depending on how many good things I have done, God will accept me or God will reject me.
Nibwira ngo bitewe n'ibyo nakoze Imana izanyemera cyangwa inyemere.
However, God does not care about how much I have worked for Him.
Ariko Imana ntirwireba ibyo twakoze ko bingana.
Because that is not the true faith.
Kubera ko si uko kwizera nyakuri.
True faith of God.
Kwizera kuri kw'Imana.
True faith according to the Bible.
Kwizera dushingiye kuri Bibiliya.
It is not human being working for God.
Ntabwo ari umuntu ukorera Imana.
But it is God working for human.
Ahubwo usanga ari Imana ikorera umuntu.
However, the religion.
Ariko mu idini.
Or, you know, religious life.
Cyangwa se ubuzima bw'idini.
It is human being trying to work for God.
Usanga ari umuntu ugerageza gukorera Imana.
Now God created all things within 5 days.
Imana yaremye ibintu byose mu minsi itanu.
And on the sixth day He also created man.
Umunsi wa gatandatu Imana irema umuntu.
And then after that God did not create anything else.
Nyuma yaho nta kindi kintu Imana yongeye kurema.
Now as soon as human being opened his eyes.
Umuntu bwabumburaga amaso ye.
Everything was prepared for him.
Ibintu byose byari byamuteguriwe.
So there was no need for him to do anything.
Ntiyari akeneye kwirirwa agira icyo akora.
Because everything he needed for life, it was already prepared for him.
Kuko buri kimwe cyose yari akeneye mu buzima cyari cyamuteguriwe.
But now he just needed one thing.
Hari ikintu kimwe yari akeneye.
What is it?
Ni iki?
Just taking a rest.
Kuruhuka.
In other words, you can say we are created to take a rest.
Mu yandi magambo twaremewe ikiruhuko.
Now we are created to take a rest in the accomplished works of God.
Twaremewe ikiruhuko mu mirimo Imana yasohoje ubwayo.
Now let's say we are created on the third day.
Rero ibaze turemwa ku munsi wa gatatu.
Now because there are also many things that are not created yet.
Kubera ko hari ibindi byari bitararemwa.
maybe you could feel that we need to contribute and do something on the work of God. However, the Bible now is illustrating exactly the true way of believing in God. Hey, when you were created, what did you need to do? Did you need to create something else? Was there any need of you, you know, adding your works on the accomplished works of God? Nothing at all. As soon as we came into existence, everything was prepared completely and perfectly. And now we just needed to take a rest. Now this one represents the gospel of Jesus Christ. When we are born again, through the complete and perfect works of Jesus Christ. Which means Jesus Christ has done everything needed for us to stand before God. But now what's wrong with this Pharisee? This Pharisee didn't need to rely on the works of Jesus. Only because he thought that his works are strong enough. He thought his works are good to be accepted by God. But now Jesus said, you know, only the tax collector came down off the mountain being justified. Now people, they are deceived into thinking that their works are good. However, we have to check what is the standard of God. Yes, you think your works are good. But have you ever checked in the eyes of God? What about the judgment of God? When he looks at you, how does he see? Many people, they never check this. Now, the standard that God wants us to use, it is his own standard. Which means if you want to be a good person, the good which is acknowledged before God, it is his own good. That is the standard. Anything below that, it is not good recognized in the eyes of God. Now, here in the book of Matthew chapter 5, verse 48, now we can read one more verse. Therefore, you shall be perfect, just as your Father in heaven is perfect. Yes, now you have to be good and stand before God. But that is good according to who? This is very important. People think, if I am recognized by others, if I recognize the church, if pastor sees me and think that I'm a good person who sacrificed themselves for the church, or want to be good among my neighbors, I want to be good at school, I want to help everyone to be acknowledged as a good Christian, a good believer, then even God will be pleased by me. Now we can see that their standard is not the standard of God. However, they rely on the standard of man. Yes, you can be good among people in your community. However, we need to check if really God also acknowledged that as good. Because here the Bible says that you shall be perfect just as your Father in heaven is perfect. Now, when I preach the gospel, sometimes I ask people this question. Hey, are you righteous? Oh yes, I'm righteous. Really?
Yego.
Yes, of course.
Yego nibyo.
Now, are you as righteous as God?
Nese ubukiranuka nk'uko Imana ikiranuka?
Then he said, no, I'm not righteous as God.
Ato yanjye ntabwo ngiranuka nk'Imana.
Of course, I'm righteous up to a certain point.
Yendo umukiranutsi kugera ku kigero runaka.
Some say like 70%.
Mirongo irindwi ku ijana.
Others say 60%.
Abandi ati mirongo itatu ku ijana.
So, just because it is more than half.
Kubera ko bijya kuba icya kabiri.
Now, they are satisfied with that.
Bakumva banyuzwe n'ibyo.
However, that is the righteous in the manners of men.
Ariko tugomba kumenya ko icyo ari gukiranuka ariko ku muntu.
Now, even if you become more righteous than everyone,
nubwo umukiranutsi karuta bose,
let's say you are righteous 90%.
Reka tuvuge ko uri umukiranutsi ku kigero cya 90%.
Now, if you don't reach the level of God,
utageze ku kigero cy'Imana,
you can't go to heaven.
Ntabwo wajya mu ijuru.
Because you can't go to heaven with 10% of sin.
Kubera ko ntabwo wajyana mu ijuru icumi ku ijana ry'ibyaha.
Even if it is 1% of sin.
Nubwo aba ari incuro imwe ku ijana, ari icyaha kimwe ku ijana.
God cannot tolerate even a single sin to go to heaven.
Imana ntiyakwihanganira icyaha kimwe nacyo kujya mu ijuru.
Now this is how people believe.
Ko niko abantu bizera.
Oh, I received salvation.
Nakira agakiza.
I have gone to the church ever since I was young.
Nagiye ku rusengero kuva naba.
Even I try to keep the laws and commandments.
Nagerageje kubahiriza amategeko n'amabwiriza.
So, I am a good person, 90%.
Ndi mwiza 90% ku ijana.
Of course, I can't say I'm good 100%.
Yego sinavuga ko ndi mwiza 100% ku ijana.
Because I'm still in this world.
Ndi ko ndacyari mu isi.
However, they confess with their mouth that I am saved. I receive salvation.
Ariko bakatura n'akanwa kabo bati ndakijijwe nakira agakiza.
Now, I'm sorry to say that God does not acknowledge that as salvation.
Ariko mumbore kubivuga icyo ntabwo Imana ikize nk'agakiza.
Why? Because that's what the Bible says.
Kubera ko ntabwo ari cyo bivuga.
The Bible says that you shall be perfect as your Father in heaven is perfect.
Bibiliya ivuga ngo mube mukiranutse nk'uko so mu ijuru akiranutse.
So how can you attain that kind of righteousness?
Ese ko gukiranuka wakugeraho ute?
Can you really be as perfect as God by your works?
Ese ko kuba mukiranutse nk'uko Imana iri binyuze mu mirimo yawe?
Because God does not have sin.
Kuko Imana ntacyagira.
God doesn't have even a single, you know, unrighteousness on him.
Imana ntigira gukiranirwa na kumwe muri yo.
Which means human being cannot attain this level of God.
Bivuze ngo umuntu ntibishobora ko yashyikira kino gipimo cy'Imana.
I mean, by his works, by what he does, he cannot be as perfect as God.
Ndavuga binyuze mu mirimo ye no kugerageza kwe ntashobora kugera ku kigero cy'Imana.
Now, let's say I'm a poor man, I'm not rich.
Reka mvuge ko ndi umukene ntakize.
Now, I'm required, let's say for example, 100 million for me to secure my house, for me to have like a place to live.
Ugasanga ndasabwa miliyoni ijana z'amadolari ngo ahantu mba habe umutekano hatekane.
Even if I cannot work and make that money.
Nubwo ntakora ngo mbone amafaranga.
Although I'm not educated.
Nubwo ntize.
Even though I don't have any other skill to make such a huge amount of money.
Nubwo nta bundi ubwenge mfite bwo gukora amafaranga nk'ayo.
Do you know Jeff Bezos? Do you know a man called Jeff Bezos?
Mozu muntu witwa Jos.
Now this is the most richest person.
Uwo muntu mvuze ni umuntu w'umukire cyane w'umuherwe.
So he has a net worth of $190 billion.
Afite amabiliyoni angana gutyo.
190 billion.
Amabiliyoni agera ku ijana na 90%.
So this is the richest man in the world.
Amajana amajana 90% amabiliyoni ni umukerewe cyane ku isi.
If this man sends me just, you know, 100 million.
Aramutse anyohereje wenda nka miliyoni ijana.
Then he gives me a call and says, I have, you know, transferred on your bank account 100 million.
Nkumva arampamagara ambwira ati konti yawe nayishyizeho amamiliyoni ijana y'amadolari.
Automatically, I'll be able to buy a house and secure a home for me to live.
Rwose icyo gihe nabasha kugura inzu imeze neza yo kubamo.
Because I have received grace from this richest person.
Kubera ko icyo gihe naba nakiri ubuntu ku muherwe nk'uwo.
Now I don't have skills, I don't have ability to make, you know, such a huge amount of money.
Nta buhanga mfite bwo gukora amafaranga angana gutyo.
But now by receiving, you know, that money as a gift from the richest man in the world.
Ariko kubwo kwakira amafaranga ku muherwe wa mbere ku isi.
Then I'm able to have it.
Nambasha kuyagira.
Now here the Bible says that you shall be perfect as your Father in heaven is perfect.
None hano biravuga ngo muzabe intungane nk'uko so mu ijuru atunganye.
When people read this scripture,
y'abantu basomye icyanditswe,
they misunderstand into thinking that we should make this righteousness on our own.
Bayumva nabi bakumva ko ari bakwiriye gukorera kuno gukiranuka.
That's why they try to keep the law.
Nyamwe bagerageza kubeza amategeko.
They try to live avoiding sin and trying to do good.
Bakagerageza kwirinda icyaha ngo bakore neza.
They strive a lot in order to fulfill this righteousness of God.
Bakora ibishoboka byose ngo bagere ku gukiranuka kw'Imana.
However, as long as man lives in this world,
ariko mu gihe cyose umuntu ariwo mwisi,
they don't have the ability to reach such a high standard of the righteousness of God.
Now washa fite bwo kugera kuri kino kigero cy'Imana.
But now why did Jesus say like this?
Yesu kuki yasavuga gutyo?
You shall be perfect as your Father in heaven is perfect.
Uzabinunga n'umuso n'ukoso mujura tunganye.
Is this possible?
Ese birashoboka?
We human being who commit sin every day.
Kagabana dukora ibyaha buri munsi.
Everything we have lust in our heart.
Tuba dufite irari rya buri munsi mu mitima yacu.
Even without you knowing, sometimes you have jealousy.
Tutanabize twumva ishyari ryaje.
All of a sudden you have greed in your heart.
Umva ugize umujinya mu mutima.
How can you be as perfect as God?
Ese wabutunganye n'Imana gute?
This can only happen if you receive it as a gift from God.
Ibyo ngibyo byabaho mu gihe wabyakiriye ku Mana nk'Imana iva kuri yo.
Now here is the secret.
Hano hari ibanga.
I cannot work and make 100 million on my own.
Ntabwo nshobora gukora ngo ngere ku madorari ijana ku bihumbi ijana by'amadorari.
However, by grace, if I get in contact with the richest person in this world,
ariko ndamutse ngiranye ubumwe n'umuntu ukize hano ku isi.
Now, if he sends me that money,
amafaranga yampaye,
I'm able to possess it just the same as the person who made it.
Mbasha kuyatunga nk'uwayakoreye.
Now, when we receive the righteousness of God,
rero twakire gukiranuka kw'Imana,
we are able to be as righteous as God.
Tubasha kuba abakiranutsi nk'uko Imana
nayo. We are able to be as perfect as God is.
Tubasha kuba intungane nk'uko Imana iri.
That is the secret of the Bible.
Iri ni ryo banga rya Bibiliya.
Therefore, God loves us and he wants us to go to heaven.
Imana yadukunda kandi ishaka ko tujya mu ijuru.
God wants us to live with him in the kingdom of heaven.
Imana ishaka ko tuzabana nawe ubwami bwo mu ijuru.
However, many people don't know this way.
Ariko abantu ibyo ntibabizi.
Because they don't know the way,
kuko batazi inzira,
they try to make it on their own.
Bagerageza kubyikoraho ubwabo.
Which means they try something impossible.
Bivuze ngo bagerageza ibintu bitashoboka.
That's why as long as we're living in this world,
niyo mpamvu igihe cyose tubaho mu isi,
we always condemn ourselves.
Tubaho twiciraho iteka.
We always find sin in our heart.
Duhora twibonaho ibyaha mu mitima yacu.
Even if you are devoted so much to serve the church, you know, to sacrifice yourself for God,
nubwo witanze ukorera Imana, ukorera umurimo w'Imana mu itorero,
but every time when you check your heart, you find yourself sinner.
Ariko urebye umutima wagiye cyose usanga uri umunyabyaha.
And condemnation is filled in your heart.
Usanga urubanza kwica urubanza n'ubundi bikiri umutima wawe.
Now here is the secret.
Ariko hano hari ibanga.
Now we are able to receive this righteousness of God as a gift from God.
Twabashije kwakira ko n'ugukiranuka kw'Imana n'Imana ituruka kuri yo.
Now the verse that we read today in the book of Matthew chapter 7.
Rero mirongo twasomye muri Matthew bice 7.
Now Jesus spoke about two different kind of houses.
Yesu yavuze ku mazu y'uburyo bubiri.
Now there is a house built on a rock and a house built on sand.
Hano hari inzu yubatse ku rutare n'iyubatse ku musenyi.
Then also Jesus spoke about two different kinds of people.
Kandi Yesu yavuze abantu b'uburyo bubiri.
One is a wise man.
Umwe ni umunyabwenge.
Another one is a foolish man.
Undi ni umupfapfa.
Who is a wise and who is a foolish?
Yesu umunyabwenge ni uwuhe, umupfapfa ni uwuhe?
So here Jesus said that the wise man is everyone who hears the sayings of mine and does them.
Biravuga ngo umunyabwenge ni uwumva amagambo kandi akayakomeza.
He who hears the word of Jesus Christ and retain it.
Bivuze ngo abumva ijambo Yesu avuga bakaribika mu mitima.
The Bible call them wise people.
Aba ngaba Yesu abita abanyabwenge.
However, those who hear the word of Jesus,
ariko abumva ijambo rya Yesu,
but now they don't care about it,
ntibaryiteho,
the Bible call them foolish people. Now, what did this wise man do? What did this foolish man do? Now, the wise man built his house on the foundation of the rock. However, the foolish person built his house on the foundation of sand. Now, think about this. When you look at these two houses,
tutekerezeho yitegereje inzu zombi.
Now on a like a bright day when there is a sunshine,
mu gihe hari akazuba k'agasusuruko,
now both houses look the same.
Izi nzu zirebye ubona ari zimwe.
It seems like there is no difference between both houses.
Ubona nta tandukaniro hagati yazo.
However, the important thing is not how the house look like. The most important thing is not with what kind of material this house is built with. Even if you build the house with a very strong material, but if the house is built on sand, one day there will be a great wind. A great tempest and flood will come and hit this house. Then all precious and expensive materials you use to build this house, everything will collapse. Now, the Bible calls this person the foolish person. However, now, the wise person. Now, this person did not give much value to the outward looking of the house. But what he gave value was the foundation of the house. Now, in this story, we can focus on the foundation. What is the rock according to the Bible? And what is sand according to the Bible? Now, this rock stands for the Word of God. And sand, you know, stands for human work. Well, we can say everything of human. His thoughts, his judgment, even his works. Now, these are the things that change according to the circumstance. Many times we change our word. Many times we change our feeling. In the morning I may feel happy, and in the evening I may feel, you know, sad. What about our works? Sometimes you may be doing good and help others. Other time you may find yourself, you know, in sinful deeds or sinful actions. Now everything of man now is described as the sand. Because it changes. However, there is something that does not change. What is that? That is the Word of God. The Word of God is the same forever and ever. Now, this is what Jesus said. The wise man is the person who hears my word and retains it in his heart. And now the foolish person is he who hears my word but does not retain it in their heart. Now we want to believe in God. So what should be the foundation of our faith? The foundation of our faith should not be our works. It should not be our feelings and emotions. Because all these are the things that change. However, if you build your faith on the Word of God, the Word of God will never change. Everyone, if you want to testify of your salvation, you should testify of what kind of word God spoke to you. What kind of promise do you have concerning your sin problem? However, many people, they have no word. And when they testify of their salvation, they speak of their works and what they did. I used to drink, but now I no longer drink. I used to smoke, but I no longer smoke. I was a fighter, but these days I don't fight. Now their salvation, their faith is based on the foundation of their works. Jesus called them foolish people. And one day when the wind will blow, when, you know, a great tempest comes, everything will collapse. Now the true salvation, the true faith, is the one that is, you know, based on the written Word of God. That's why if you want to confirm your salvation, you should say, Jesus promised me like this. God spoke to me like this concerning my sin problem. If you don't have that promise, please read the Bible. Listen to the Word of God. You try to receive the Word of God, the promise concerning your sin problem.
Yageze kwakira isezerano ry'Imana, ijambo ry'Imana.
So I myself, for my salvation, I received this promise in the book of Hebrews, chapter 10, verse 10.
Ye kubwanjye kujyanye n'ibyaha byanjye isezerano ryakiranwa bibora bice 10 umurongo wa 10.
I will read that verse before I end.
Reka dusome umurongo mbere yuko nsoza.
Hebrews chapter 10 verse 10.
Abiheburayo igice cya 10 umurongo wa 10.
By that will we have been sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all.
Avuga ati ko gushaka kw'Imana niko kwatumye twezwa tubeshejwe nuko umubiri wa Yesu watambwe imwe gusa ngo bihagije iteka.
Now we can read once more slowly so that we can understand this scripture.
Reka twongere dusubiremo neza kugira ngo tucyumve iki cyanditswe.
By that will we have been sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all.
Ko gushaka kw'Imana niko kwatumye twezwa tubeshejwe nuko umubiri wa Yesu watambwe imwe gusa ngo bibe bihagije iteka.
Now when I was preached this word, I received it as mine.
Ubwo numvaga iri jambo naryakiriye nk'iryanyu.
God, you are speaking to me.
Burya Mana ni kumvugisha.
That by your will I have been sanctified.
Ku gushaka kw'Imana kwawe niko kwatumye neza.
This is in the past tense.
In the revoked diocese.
Which means I have been already sanctified.
Bivuze ngo narejejwe.
It's not that I'm being sanctified right now.
Ntabwo ngiye kwezwa none.
It's not that I'll be sanctified in the future.
Ntabwo nzezwa mu gihe kiri imbere.
The Bible says that I have been sanctified.
Ahubwo bivuga ko namaze kwezwa.
By whose will?
Ubushake bwa nde?
The Bible says that by the will of God.
Ubwo ubushake bw'Imana.
Now, if it was by the will of man,
ubushake bw'umuntu,
this sanctification wouldn't be perfect.
Kwezwa niko ari kuba gutunganya.
Man could not sanctify me fully.
Umuntu ntabwo yantunganya mu buryo bushyitse.
However, the Bible says that it is by the will of God.
Ariko hano biravuga ngo ni ugushaka kw'Imana.
And I have been already sanctified.
Rero nari narejejwe kuva kera.
Which means if I am sanctified by the will of God, it means I am already a saint. It means I am already a holy person. And how was it done? The Bible says that through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ only once for all.
Yavuga ngo ni kubwo igitambo cy'umubiri wa Yesu Kristo gusa byakozwe inshuro imwe kugeza iteka.
Now from this time I could understand why Jesus was crucified for me.
Kugeza ubu rero mbasha kumva impamvu Yesu yambambiwe.
Ever since I was young I was taught Jesus was crucified for me.
Nkiri muto nabwiwe ko Yesu yambambiwe.
But I didn't know why he was crucified for me.
Ako sinumvaga mu by'ukuri impamvu yabambiwe.
However when I received this word as mine,
ariko ubwo nakiraga iri jambo nk'iryanjye,
now I came to understand.
Naje kubyumva.
This is why Jesus shed his blood.
Ate se buryo niyo mpamvu Yesu yamennye amaraso ye.
This is why he was bruised.
Niyo mpamvu yakubiswe.
It is forced to start to sanctify me.
Kwari ukugira ngo ansindishirije.
This is why whenever I testify about my salvation,
niyo mpamvu nawe uhamya ibyaha kuko nakize ibyaha.
I speak to people that I am holy.
Mbwira abantu ni ndi uwera.
I am righteous.
Ndi umukiranutsi.
I am perfect 100%.
Ndatunganye ijana ku ijana.
How?
Gute?
Through the offering of the body of Jesus once for all.
Binyuze mu gitambo kimwe ari cyo umubiri wa Yesu Kristo.
This is the word of God.
Iri ni ijambo ry'Imana.
Now my faith is based on the word of God.
Rero kwizera kwanjye kushingiye ku ijambo ry'Imana.
The word of God does not change.
Ijambo ry'Imana ryo ntirinduka.
This is why even the faith or the righteousness based on that word will never change.
Niyo mpamvu gukiranuka gukoreshwa no kwizera iryo jambo nako ntiguhinduka.
Now this is the rock Jesus was talking about in the book of Matthew chapter 7.
Uru ni rwo rutare Yesu yavugaga muri Matayo bice 7.
However, before then,
mbere,
I used to base my faith on my works.
Mbere najyaga nabanaga no kwizera gushingiye ku mirimo yanjye.
Now when I was in the church, you know, praising God, praying, I could feel that I'm righteous.
Igihe nabaga ni mu rusengero mpimbaza Imana nsenga numvaga nkiranuka.
However, after I go out meeting my friends, I could commit sin and say that now I'm a sinner.
Nagera hanze ngakora ibyaha n'inshuti zanjye nkongera ngishaho iteka ni umunyabyaha.
So my faith could change continuously every time.
Mpamvu asaba kwizera nabanaga nako guhindagurika.
That is the foundation of the sin.
Rero uno umusingi w'umusenyi.
Dear followers,
abakurikiye,
please think about your heart and think about your faith.
Ntekereza ku mitima yanyu no kwizera mu bana nako.
What if Jesus comes right now?
Sese aje nonaha.
What if the trumpet, sounds right now?
Ese Imana ivuze akanya.
Are you really confident that you can be accepted by God? If it is not so, it's because your faith is based on your works. You need to throw everything. You need to learn the word of God from the beginning. It is not something shameful. Because some people they want to hold their dignity. Like when we have salvation, when we have fellowship and we hear that they are not clear in the word of God, you tell them you have not received salvation. Even though you spent 10, 20 years in the church, but according to your faith, you have not received salvation. Some people, they become angry and they close their heart. Because they just want to hold their dignity. What is good for you to hold your dignity and end up into hellfire? We don't know when Jesus Christ will come back. But if Jesus come back right now and find that you're not righteous, woe to you. That would be, you know, a very sad, you know, misery. Now, if you think that you're not as righteous as God at this moment, the only reason is because your faith is built on the Son, which is your works. Now, I'm saying you throw everything. And now you start to learn this word of God one by one from the beginning. God is willing to save you. I believe God will lead you into the truth. So I sincerely urge you to keep following this evening fellowship. And through this, I have no doubt that you are going to meet the truth. Then you shall partake with the church to spread this gospel to all people. Yeah, thank you very much. So tonight we'll share up to here. Let me pray and we end. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you for this moment you have given us to share your word. Father, many times we have been building our faith on the changing works of man. This is why Jesus said that these people, they are called foolish. So Father, we want to build our faith on the foundation of the rock, which is the word of God. Because the word does not change. And the Bible says in the book of John chapter 1 verse 1, in the beginning there was the word was with God, and the word was God. Which means this word itself is Jesus Christ. Father, when we build our faith to Jesus Christ, we shall not perish at all. However, you shall receive us happily in the kingdom of heaven. Lord, I pray that this gospel be spread to all people in all the corners of the world. Allow all these listeners to be the partakers to take this gospel to all people they know. Father, we believe that we will live forever in your kingdom. Thank you. We pray all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, thank you very much. See you next time.